Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be reviewing the Eucerin Daily Protection Face Lotion and Sunscreen SPF 30. This is a hybrid sunscreen that uses chemical and mineral filters. I recently talked about this in my top 5 drugstore sunscreens, and this ranked at number 1. I'm gonna get into all the details, everything you need to know. I'll show you what it looks like on my bare skin and under makeup, and of course, share with you my final thoughts. But before I do so, if you love all things skincare, make sure you subscribe because that's all we do on this channel. Now let's go ahead and get into today's review. Now let's kick off this review by talking a little bit about some of the features of this sunscreen. So it is by the brand Eucerin. We are getting 4 fluid ounces, which is not the typical amount you would get in a sunscreen. Typically you would get 2 fluid ounces, so you're getting double the amount you would get usually. And it retails for $8.99. So if you do the math, this is a very affordable, probably less than $5 for 2 ounces. It's a broad spectrum sunscreen, so it offers UVA and UVB protection. It is also fragrance free and non-comedogenic. It says here that it moisturizes and helps protect skin against daily UVA and UVB exposure. If you can see, all Eucerin products have this scale on them that goes from like light viscosity to the heaviest, and this ranks on the 2nd lightest. So quite a lightweight sunscreen. It is a hybrid, as I mentioned in my intro, so it means it uses mineral and chemical filters. Actually, this sunscreen uses 5 filters. 3 of them are chemical and 2 of them are mineral. It also claims to be fast absorbing and to have a non-greasy finish. Let's dive deeper into the ingredients, specifically the active ingredients, so the ones that are doing the protection. The first one is called Insulazol, and it's at a concentration of 2%, and this is mainly responsible for UVB protection, and it is highly photostable and commonly used around the world. The second chemical filter is octinoxate, and it is used at a 7.5%. This is a commonly used chemical filter. It is used all over the world, but one issue with it is that it's not very stable, so it does require another filter in the formulation to stabilize it. But the good thing about it is that it is cosmetically elegant. It also only provides UVB protection. The final and 3rd chemical filter in this formulation is octisalate, and it is used at a 4.5%. This chemical filter is only responsible for UVB protection, but isn't very stable, just like octinoxate, and it does require to be used with another stable filter. Let's move on to the mineral filters. We've got 2 of them here. The first one being titanium dioxide, and it is used at a 2.4%. Titanium dioxide offers UVA 2 and UVB protection, so it doesn't offer any UVA 1 protection. We're getting UVA protection in this formulation with the final filter. It is zinc oxide, and it comes at a percentage of 4.8. Zinc oxide is like the king of all filters. It offers UVA 1, 2, and UVB protection, so it is broad spectrum on its own. It is highly stable. It is like the golden standard in sunscreens, so it's great to see it in this formulation. I would say the sunscreen is truly broad spectrum. It is covering UVA 1, 2, and UVB, and you don't always find that in a lot of sunscreens. The only thing to note about the sunscreen is that it's not water resistant, so if you are going for a swim, or you know you're gonna be sweating or doing some type of sports, then this is not going to be your first choice. It's better you opt for a water resistant sunscreen. I'm gonna go ahead and show you what it looks like on my hand so you have an idea. I put a full pump. It does have a slight white cast, but that actually tends to disappear once you work it into your skin, which I'm gonna do right now and show you what it looks like once it's been absorbed. It has a very lotiony type of a consistency. It's very lightweight, and it does have a little bit of a sheen. If you have very oily skin, this might not be a great one for you. But if you have normal to oily skin type, you might enjoy this in winter, specifically considering that it's not water resistant and the SPF on it is 30, not 50. This would be a great option to wear in winter time. It is very moisturizing and this might work for a lot of you without having to wear a face moisturizer under it. As you can see on my skin tone, the white cast completely disappeared, and I will say even if you wait for around 20 minutes, it doesn't dry down completely, but it's not heavy or thick. It doesn't sit on top of the skin and you cannot feel it sitting heavy. So the white cast on this is definitely very minimal. Now, I cannot speak for a very deep skin tone. I really don't know what this would look like, but I would say if you were to wear it under makeup, then foundation would definitely cover the white cast if any was left. You will be seeing me applying it on my bare skin right now on camera. You can see it goes on quite nicely, just like any other lightweight face lotion. It blends into the skin. You can initially see a little bit of a white cast, but then that tends to disappear as I rub it into my skin. It feels very moisturizing. I was also able to apply it around my eyes. It didn't irritate my eyes right on application or even throughout the day, as that tends to happen sometimes with other sunscreens, but this one didn't. I waited for around 20 minutes to see how this will set. It did set a little bit. If I were to touch my skin, I could definitely feel it there, but it wasn't anything too sticky, too greasy, or too heavy. With that being said, you can see it does offer a little bit of a shine on the face, that type of a glowy look, which a lot of people enjoy. Then you might not enjoy this. Then I went ahead and applied makeup on top. I definitely noticed that my skin felt very moisturized and foundation applied on top of it quite smoothly. It did give me slightly that polka dotty look, but I know how to work that out. I just blend in my foundation with a beauty blender, blend it really well, and that tends to disappear. Even after applying my foundation and powder on top of it, I was still able to see that glowy look under my makeup. And I kind of enjoy it. If you're someone who wants that matte look, this is not gonna give you that. My final thoughts of the sunscreen. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I love this sunscreen. It is so cosmetically elegant. It is beautiful on the skin. It kind of minimizes my steps in the morning. I really don't feel like I need to use a moisturizer under it. This moisturizes my skin just enough. And you know, with the price point, you can't go wrong. You get it in a beautiful packaging. The pump is absolutely amazing. It is really nice. It dispenses the right amount of product. It blends into the skin beautifully. What else can I ask for? It's fragrance free, non-comedogenic. The only thing is that I would wish them to come out with a sunscreen similar to this, but in a water resistant formula with a slightly higher SPF, let's say SPF 50. Other than that, cannot complain about anything. So affordable, elegant, no white cast, sits really well under makeup, no fragrance. Really, it ticks all the boxes for me. I absolutely recommend it. If you've been eyeing it and you're not sure whether you wanna pick it up or not, I hope this video was helpful to you. I buy mine off of iHerb. They ship worldwide. I love their service. I do have a discount code that you can use. It is an affiliated code, so feel free to use it or not, but if you do, thank you. And if you're on the hunt for the best drugstore sunscreen, I have a whole playlist of drugstore sunscreens on my channel. I will leave a link to it up here. And yeah, that is it. I will leave all the details in my description box if you want to refer to them later on. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for my future content, and I shall see you in my next one. Bye guys!